Einstein, where'd you go now, boy?
Excuse me, young man!
Who? Me?
You're the only man in the street, and I'm looking for a man-in-the-street reaction. Naturally, you know about the explosion that destroyed this illegal gin establishment.
I read about it, yeah.
What's your opinion of Carl Sagan, the stranger who single-handedly did what the law has been unable to do for 10 long years, namely, rid Hill Valley of the scourge of liquor?
There's gotta be some sort of mistake here. Carl wouldn't do something like that.
It's surprising the lengths a person will go to when it's a clear-cut matter of right and wrong. You've got an honest look about you. You do support the side of righteousness, I trust.
How'd Doc get himself into...
Doc?
Doc is his nickname. I'm good friends with Carl.
You are? Really? Oh, but I need an unbiased opinion for my story. Pretend you don't know him. How would you feel about his heroic act of destruction?
Well, I'm not so big on bomb blasts.
Yes, but this bomb blasted a speakeasy, the very symbol of lawlessness and corruption. You're all for cleaning up the town, aren't you? Do you have a message for the vicious gangsters who still roam these streets, no doubt plotting to corrupt our citizens with another den of booze, sin, and debauchery?
Ask him where I can get the address.
Ah, I see! Because you want to blast it to smithereens, just like Carl Sagan did. With public-spirited citizens like you around, the lawless element will be on the run in no time. Mr. May I get your name?
Yeah, it's... Michael Corleone.
Thank you for sharing your candid opinions, Mr. Corleone. Edna Strickland, Hill Valley Herald.
I know. I met you back. I mean, I'm familiar with your work.
You read my column? How sweet! I know it's just an etiquette column, but I believe it'll lead to bigger and better...
Oh! Einstein, no! Down, boy!
Is this wretched creature yours? He assaulted me once before!
What's got into you?
Aggressive dogs must be kept on leash at all times. It's the law. Look it up!
Doc. I gotta find Doc. Wow, looks like they used a real shark. I'm not so sure I want to stay in a place that welcomes transients. Hey, can I get some moose?
What does this look like, a hunting lodge?
Buy anything?
No.
Then get out, Bob.
I guess this is where the speakeasy burned down. How'd Doc ever get mixed up in that? Gale, Zemeckis, and Fine. Attorneys at law. No solicitors. Lamont's House of Ermine. I guess there's not much call for fur coats in the middle of the Depression, especially in June. Hill Valley Stationers. Wow, this place has been around forever. Majestic Arms. Transients welcome. Hello?
No solicitors!
Bank of Italy? Where is the jail in 1931 anyway?
How can I help you, sir?
Without any money, I don't really have any business in there. McFly! Biff? Kid! Grandpa?
That's Mr. Tannen to you, Artie. What are you doing out here?
Well, I was getting kind of hungry, so I figured I'd come down here for some free soup.
Just thought I'd come down for some soup. Think, McFly! The DA's throwing around subpoenas like Babe Ruth.
I don't think Ruth's a pitcher anymore.
Shut it! If one of those subpoenas landed in the hands of my number cruncher, I'd be in a whole lot of trouble. I could even get sent up the river. You wouldn't want that, would you? Would you?
No, of course not, kid.
All right, that's better. What are you looking at, punk?
Keep your eyes on the soup, kid.
Well?
Well, what?
What are you still doing here?
Sorry, kid, I'll just... run back to the safe house.
You do that. And McFly?
Yes?
That hat's too flashy. You better let me hold on to it. Now scram!
You got it, boss.
And don't come out until I give you the all clear. I swear, if even one of you mooks could add 2 + 2 without your fingers, I'd dump that wimp into the lake. Hey! Anyway, I'm off to make myself irresistible. Don't let anyone burn down the shop while I'm gone.
Okay. Hey, never mind. What are those tables for?
We keep a few extra tables around for our end-of-the-month hobo soirees.
Nice rack.
Yeah, we got all kinds of culinary enhancements back there. The kitchen's for management only, Rummy.
Whoa! Looks like these pipes go into the basement. I better not talk to him. I don't want to mess up his timeline. There's no way I'm gonna keep that door open without some help. Like a thorn bush in a drunkard's hand is a proverb in the mouth of a fool. Heavy. Lazy hands make a man poor, but diligent hands bring wealth. Maybe that's my problem. Lazy hands. Maybe I should go to the jail and talk to Doc before I start dialing random people in 1931. Hey, how you doing, Einie? According to the newspaper, Doc's not in the courthouse. He's in jail. I can sightsee later. Right now, I've got to find the doc. Sisters of Mercy Soup Kitchen. Come for the soup, stay for the salvation. Hill Valley Police Station. Cripes, this place looks old, even for 1931.
Who are you and what do you want?
Can I talk to, Carl Sagan?
Are you his lawyer?
No.
Then scram!
Doc!
Marty!
Doc!
What are you doing here?
You sent for me, Doc.
I did? When?
May 14th, 1986.
1980? The automatic retrieval system, of course. I'd almost forgotten about that.
So what's our plan for getting you out of here?
Plan? We don't need a plan.
We don't?
Not in the slightest. The police picked me up for that speakeasy fire a couple of weeks ago, but the DA hasn't got a case. They're releasing me tomorrow morning.
So basically, I traveled 50 years into the past to deliver your car?
Sorry about that. But it's so wonderful to see you. We have a lot of catching up to do.
Yeah, you might want to hold off on that, Doc.
Great Scott! I'm going to be gunned down by gangsters on the steps of the courthouse!
Why would they do that?
Guess they didn't approve of my burning down their speakeasy.
Very funny, Doc. Maybe now we should come up with a plan?
A plan? Right. But what?
Why don't I take the DeLorean, go back in time before you were arrested, and stop you from getting caught in the first place?
Don't even think about it. Without my unjust incarceration, the events that sent you into the past might never happen, resulting in a paradox of continuum-shattering proportions.
Jeez, we've been back together for 5 minutes, Doc, and you're already talking about the end of the universe. I've missed that.
Don't be ridiculous, Marty. I was only referring to the end of the universe as we know it.
Why don't we tell the authorities?
Tell them what? That my friend from the future has proof that I'll be murdered tomorrow? They'd ship us both off to the loony bin. And trust me, you don't want to see the inside of a 1931 insane asylum.
Why don't we try to tough it out? Now that we know what's coming, maybe we sneak it past the gangsters with a bulletproof vest or something.
That might work with one or two bullets, but from the looks of this article, it appears that I'm going to be mowed down in a hail of Tommy gunfire that rendered the innocent stranger little more than a pulpy mass of bones and gristle.
Who writes like that?
According to the byline, one Edna Strickland.
I should have guessed. Hey, maybe I could talk to the gangsters. Tell them they're about to shoot the wrong guy.
I don't think the criminals of this era are going to be very receptive to a complete stranger telling them that their secret assassination plan is misguided, do you?
Well, I suppose I could just get some dynamite and break you out of jail.
No, that's far too dangerous. Not just to me, but to random innocent people in the past. The repercussions could be That's it!
What's it?
My rocket-powered drill.
You have a rocket-powered drill?
Not yet. I haven't built it yet.
You've lost me, Doc.
Listen, a few months ago, my 17-year-old self sent in a patent application for a rocket-powered drill. I abandoned the project after I never heard back from the patent office, but the prototype should be nearly complete.
Great, I'll just run back to your lab and...
No, I said nearly complete. You'll need me to help you finish it.
How the hell am I supposed to sneak a half-finished rocket-powered drill into your cell?
Not me, me! 1931 me!
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to convince your 1931 self to build a rocket-powered drill to break you out of jail?
Precisely!
Won't talking to yourself cause, you know, irreparable damage to the space-time continuum or something?
It should be fine. I've already invented the idea of the rocket drill. You've just got to goad my younger self into finishing the prototype.
How am I supposed to convince your younger self to finish the rocket drill? Just tell him I need to break his older self out of jail?
Absolutely not. Whatever you do, you can't tell my younger self anything about time travel. I won't come up with the inspiration for the flux capacitor for another 24 years.
Then what am I supposed to...
Just be your charming self. From what I remember, I'm a pretty easygoing kid, so enlisting me in a scientific adventure should be a piece of cake.
Okay, let's say I go along with this crazy idea. Where can I find you? I mean, the other you.
How should I know? It was over 50 years ago. Why don't you go over to the soup kitchen next door and give my house a call? They'll know where to find me.
Soup kitchen. Got it.
Just stay away from the soup. It'll cause irreparable damage to your digestive system.
I guess I better get started. Don't worry, Doc. I'll get you out of here in no time.
I'm not worried. Once you and my younger self put your heads together, you'll be unstoppable.
Psst, Doc!
Marty! Have you found my younger self yet?
How do you remember this phone number after 50 years?
It's a mnemonic for a dirty punchline I learned when I was 12. Now, get to the soup kitchen and find out where I am.
Where have you been all this time? I missed you.
I've missed you too, Marty. But I thought it was important to let you live your own life for a while, free from the insanity of time travel.
I gotta admit, it was nice to not have my family history blowing up in my face for a few months.
Besides, I've been busy raising my own unpredictable teenagers.
So how are Clara and the kids?
They're fine, fine. Right now we're trying to decide where to send Jules and Vern to college. Clara prefers the 2020s, but I'm partial to the 1960s. We're planning on visiting you and Jennifer in 2011 soon.
Me and Jennifer? In 2011?
Forget I said anything.
Where'd the DeLorean come from? The last time I saw it had been smashed to pieces by a train.
It's a fantastic story. Do you remember when the DeLorean got struck by lightning in 1955?
Yeah?
Unbeknownst to either of us, the lightning produced a temporal duplicate of the time machine, one that was tossed 70 years into the future.
What?
I found out about it during a trip to 2025 and recovered it just in time to stop Griff Tannen from vandalizing the time stream.
Heavy. So that DeLorean...
is for all intents and purposes the exact same machine as the original. Plus or minus little bells and whistles I've added over the years, of course.
So, what were you doing in 1931 anyway?
Oh, nothing terribly exciting. Indulging in a little personal nostalgia, picking up a few rare out-of-print books to surprise Clara on her birthday, solving a historical mystery or two. The usual.
The usual? You lead a pretty unusual life, Doc.
It's an unusual universe, Marty.
I hate to tell you, Doc, but your last time departed display is on the fritz.
It is? So how did you find me?
I found one of Edna Strickland's shoes in the DeLorean.
How did one of her shoes get in the DeLorean?
Einstein took it from her.
He did? How strange. Einie almost never attacks people. Not without a good reason, anyway.
How'd you wind up in jail in 1931 anyway?
During my trip to the past, I decided to look into one of Hill Valley's unsolved mysteries.
The fire at the speakeasy.
Exactly. I thought I was safely hidden across the street. But when the fire started, there was a tremendous explosion, and I was knocked unconscious by a stray brick. When I woke up, I was here in jail, charged with arson.
That's horrible.
I know. Worse yet, I still don't know who started the fire.
Guess who I bumped into at the soup kitchen? My grandfather.
No!
Don't worry, I didn't talk to him or change his future or anything.
Good.
I wish I could, though. This era's tannin is treating him like dirt.
Don't worry. If history plays out as it's supposed to, he'll soon be out from under Kit Tannin's thumb and free to live out his life as a humble accountant with your grandma. What was her name again?
Sylvia.
Right, Sylvia.
What's the story with this Kid Tannin jerk anyway?
Liv's father? By this time next year, he'll be pulling down a life sentence in San Quentin. There was even a song about it.
Wait, if Biff will be born in 1938, and Kid will be in prison...
As I recall, he escaped from prison in 1937 for about 3 hours.
That's a busy 3 hours.
No kidding.
What do you know about Edna Strickland?
Edna? We never really socialized when I was younger. She was a few years older than me, and we traveled in different socioeconomic circles. Why do you ask?
She thinks you're a hero for burning down that speakeasy. She's doing a story on you.
A story? Oh, yes, now I remember. Ask Edna, the etiquette column that doubled as a pro-temperance soapbox. She believed that the consumption of alcohol would inevitably lead to a complete societal breakdown.
Sounds like a fun gal.
You should have seen her when the hippies started showing up in the 60s. She just somehow lost her mind.
That would explain a lot. I know this really isn't the right time or place, but I found your notebook.
Oh, so that's where I left it. Why'd you bring it here?
Because the bank's selling off all your stuff.
They can't do that.
That's what I keep trying to tell them.
Well, you hold on to it for safekeeping. We'll deal with my financial situation in 1986, after we save me from a grisly death in 1931.
Hang in there, Doc.
Not the best choice of words, Marty.
After all the trouble I went through getting this thing, there's no way I'm letting it out of my sight. I think I'll just talk to Doc from out here. Hi. Do you know where I could find Emmett Brown?
Young Master Brown is currently tending to his clerking duties at the courthouse. Who may I say is calling?
The courthouse? Doc never told me he worked at the courthouse.
Brown results?
Those. These are very sensitive legal documents. Nobody is supposed to handle them but sworn officers of the court. Judge Brown says so.
Judge Brown? Doc. Nice to meet you. I'm Michael, Corleone.
Emmett Brown. But I am a law clerk, not a doctor. Now please get out of my way. I have important business to transact. Naturally, H2A multiplied by the inversion of H has to come out of...
Listen, Emmett, you don't know me, but I'm your friend.
I'm not big on friends. They get in the way of work.
What's this important business you're up to?
It's a legal matter. Very complicated, very abstruse. I need to obtain 5 sets of initials on every copy of this writ of indemnification before Pop... before Judge Brown can even think of granting a waiver to the party in the first part.
You have no idea what it's about, do you?
That's how important it is.
Come on, Doc. Emmett, drop the legal eagle act. I got something more important for you to do.
Mr. Corleone, I'll have you know that the law is the very mortar that holds society together. And we in the legal profession are like brick masons building the edifice of the future.
Your dad tell you that?
Every morning.
So, Emmett, what time are you through with work?
Depends. On weeknights, Pop sometimes keeps me in the office till 9.
9 at night? But today's Saturday.
Right. So I probably won't get off before 10.
How about you knock off work early and I'll buy you a beer, or soda. What do you say?
Don't try to tempt me from my duty with sugary beverages. Keeping the wheels of justice turning, that's my one passion in life. Besides, if I left before 8, my pop would kill me.
Sounds like you're a little scared of your father.
Scared of my father? Pop is the most learned, just, incorruptible judge that Hill Valley has ever seen. The only people scared of Judge Brown are people with a dark secret to hide. And I don't have a dark secret to hide.
Listen, I understand you're working on a new invention in your lab.
Invention? You must have me mixed up with somebody else. I'm in law. I have absolutely no interest in science. A multiplied by the...
Come on, wait up a minute.
You again? Can't you see I'm busy?
Okay, so you don't want your old man to know. That's fine. Listen, we all keep secrets. But I'm telling you, you can level with me about this science project of yours.
I am not a scientist. Go ahead, ask me what E equals.
What does E equal?
I have absolutely no idea. See? I don't know where you got your information from about me, mister, but you're wrong, wrong, wrong. Oh, let's stop.
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Corleone.
Come on, you could trust me, Doc. Emmett, it's your future I'm looking out for, in more ways than one.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you and science.
Oh, that word again! If you insinuate I'm a scientist once more, I'll sue you for defamation of character! Verse of a derivative of a...
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Corleone.
See, I'm sort of in the science business myself. That's why I sought you out.
Not that I care in the least, because science is the furthest thing from my own area of interest, which is law, but I don't believe you.
It's true. I'm a scientist.
So tell me something, Mr. Scientist, from your vast storehouse of scientific knowledge.
The leg bone's connected to the thigh bone?
Amazing.
Emmett, about
Don't
your...
Don't say it.
After all the trouble I went through getting this thing, there's no way I'm letting it out of my sight. Doc's notebook doesn't belong to him. Okay, actually, it does belong to him, but not yet. In any event, it's probably a really bad idea to give him a book full of all the things he hasn't invented yet.
Later, then naturally H2A multiplied by the inversion of H has to come out less than expectation value of A, right? No, what am I missing here?
Nah.
Oh, well, no.
think that picture's gonna do anything but confuse people.
Not possible. Now if H stands for one...
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Corleone!
Damn it. About your...
Don't say it! Right, no, no. What am I missing? Oh, think, Emmett, think! H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. Only if the coefficient of friction remains constant and the gravitational constant is variable. Wait, is that even possible? Oh, let's start over. Force equals mass times acceleration, of course. That's...
So, Doc, does this ring a bell?
H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A.
Good grief! Is that me? I sound so...
young?
I was gonna say intense. I forgot how wound up I used to get.
Yeah, but what are you muttering about?
Oh, that's easy. It's Ivanov's conundrum. Just tell my younger self that H equals the Hamiltonian operator.
Won't giving him the answer mess up the time stream?
Only if it turns out that reality is actually nothing more than a holographic illusion created by the interplay of subatomic particles on a vast two-dimensional membrane.
So...
it'll be fine.
One-dimensional harmonic oscillator, then naturally H2A multiplied by the inversion of H has to come out less than expectation value of A, right? No, no, no. What am I missing here?
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Corleone!
Maybe H equals the Hamiltonian operator.
What did you just say?
I said maybe H equals the...
Hamiltonian operator?
Yeah!
Great Scott! If H is a Hamiltonian, then H to the A multiplied by the inverse of H can only be the same as the expectation value for A! That's it! That's the solution to Ivanov's conundrum, the problem I've been wrestling with in my head all week!
I'm sure you would have figured it out by yourself in a day or two, the way you figured out how to build that rocket-powered drill.
Where did you learn so much about science?
Well, it's like this.
You know about my rocket power drill? Then there can only be one explanation.
What?
You're from the patent office. I confess I didn't quite know what to expect when I sent the paperwork, but I never expected this. Welcome! I'm at your service. What can I do for you?
Can I see your rocket power drill?
Of course, of course. Naturally, it's just a scale model, but it's nearly operational. I can show it to you, say, first thing in the morning.
Nah, that's no good. I need to see a full-size model. That's fully operational. Tonight. Otherwise, we'll have to award the patent to a competing inventor, Dr. McCoy.
It can't be done! I mean, it might be possible to construct a full-size working model in that time frame, but I haven't got the main ingredient for the fuel.
I'll get it for you. What is it?
190-proof grain alcohol. And you know how difficult it is to get a hold of alcohol these days.
Especially now that someone's blown up the speakeasy.
And besides, there's no way I can get off work until I've delivered the subpoena. Part of the investigation into the business affairs of Kid Tannen. Is it vitally important you see that rocket power drill today?
Yes. Is it vitally important you deliver that subpoena today?
Yes!
Listen, I'll help you deliver it, and I'll see to it you get the alcohol you need. It'll help you get that drill finished by tonight. Deal?
Deal. Here's the subpoena.
I've got a subpoena my grandpa.
No! It's Kid Tannen!
Hey, I just saw him at the soup kitchen, yelling at Arthur McFly.
I'm not surprised. Arthur does the books for his business.
What kind of business?
That's what the DA is trying to find out.
Let's go talk to him.
No!
Why not? Kid Tannen can tell us where Arthur's hiding.
Yeah, well, he can also have us fitted for a Chicago overcoat.
You have to deliver a lot of subpoenas?
Father's always sending me out to do these dirty jobs. He wants to expose me to different kinds of people. All he's exposed me to is a lot of new curse words.
If serving subpoenas is such dirty work, why don't you just say no?
Look, what's the worst thing that can happen to me on this job?
You could get shot.
Yeah, well, believe me, that's nothing compared to what I'll get if I mouth off to my pop.
Any idea where we could find Artie?
Not a jot. If only we had a way of tracking him.
This subpoena's for Arthur McFly?
Have you seen him?
For a few seconds in the soup kitchen, but I think he's gone back into hiding.
Brilliant deduction, Einstein.
What do you know about Arthur McFly?
Certified accountant. Graduated Hill Valley 5 classes ahead of me. Seems like a nice fellow, actually.
How did he get mixed up with a guy like Kid Tannen?
Who knows? Sometimes people find themselves stuck in situations they can't get out of.
How about Kid Tannen? What do we know about him?
He's loud, he's obnoxious, he's not very bright, and he doesn't like anybody getting in his way.
Yep, that's a Tannen, all right. This might be a stupid question, but couldn't you have designed your rocket-powered drill to run on fuel that, you know, isn't illegal?
Illegal? What does law have to do with science? Science has its own laws. You of all people should know that.
But couldn't you tweak your engine design a little so it runs on something else?
Like what?
I don't know. Gas, maybe?
Gasoline? Yesterday's news. You'll see. By 1940, automobiles will all run on pure alcohol.
Some of us down at the patent office are wondering, what made you think of a rocket-powered drill?
Ah, that'd be Journey to the Center of the Earth by Jules Verne. It was a revelation.
Yeah, that's kind of what we figured. Have you read The Time Machine?
H.G. Wells? Not yet, but it's on my list.
We'll get that subpoena delivered. My name isn't...
Michael Corleone!
Yeah! Nice bike. Huffy?
Huffy? I'm not huffy. I'm passionate. Passionate about justice, safety, law, and order.
Never mind. Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Corleone. Try not to draw any undue attention my way. I'm on the trail of a hot new scoop, as we in the newspaper business say.
What's the scoop?
I've heard rumors that something shady is going on at the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen. It's under new management, you know. And, oh, we mustn't jump to any conclusions, not till the facts are in. I hope to heaven it is just a rumor. That soup kitchen is the front line in the good fight. If it goes bad, what will happen to the Stay Sober Society? Not to mention all the charitable institutions that depend on me for soup deliveries.
Did you finish the story you interviewed before? About Carl Sagan?
Yes, but those pig-headed editors at the paper rejected it. They said my story was slanted, and that I was glorifying a suspected arsonist. As if their stories aren't always glorifying the criminal vermin that run this town. This whole thing makes me so mad I could spit! Oh, of course, I never would. There's an ordinance against it, and it's so untidy.
What's the Stay Sober Society?
You haven't heard of the SSS? They do the most marvelous work, taking hopeless drunken bums and turning them into former hopeless drunken bums. I'm one of the founding members. And not to say that I was ever, well, you know, Anyway, we've always met in the cellar of the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen, but for some reason, the new managers don't want us down there, so we're stuck. We've got nowhere to meet.
I'm sorry about the way Einstein lit into you back there. I don't know what got into him.
Well, I hope you've learned to keep him under control.
Yeah, I found someone to keep him distracted.
Very good. Now let's see if you know your multiplication tables.
You make hot soup deliveries?
It's one of my many small contributions to the good cause. Healthy bodies, healthy souls, or so one hopes. I pick up barrels of hot soup at the kitchen, and I deliver them hither and thither. Hill Valley Orphanage, the St. Francis Xavier Ranch for Unwanted Children, Foggy Mountain Home for the Incurably Insane, Shady Acres Rest Home. Oh, I can barely keep track of them all. It's a very big job.
Hey, I can help you deliver soup. I donate a lot of time to charities.
Oh? Which ones?
The, Mario Brothers.
Ah, yes. The Italians do so many good works.
If you'll just fix it so I can pick up the barrels of soup.
Now hold your horses, let's not get overeager. I drive the soup cycle in this town, and I'm not about to turn it over to an upstart. But if you're well-connected with the local charitable institutions...
Yeah?
You can let me know when they're running low on soup.
As a matter of fact, I do know a local charity that's running low on soup.
Oh? Who?
The Insane Asylum.
Whose inmates are crazy for soup? All right, Edna. Just think of all those poor unfortunates and hold your nose. Mr. Donnelly!
Hell, Matches. You got kiwi all over my socks!
Sorry, boss.
Get out of here. How about you?
Huh?
I'm sitting at a shoe shine booth. You walk up. Either you're here to shine my shoes, or you got a death wish. Which is it?
I guess you won't talk about your business.
Why not? I got nothing to hide. I recently acquired controlling interest in the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen.
Isn't a soup kitchen an odd line of business for a guy like you?
I like soup. Plus, I got a heart as big as all outdoors. Buff a little harder. I want to see myself in the toes.
I'm looking for a guy named Arthur McFly. He's my... sort of a relative.
Well, he's my employee. He's very busy today.
Since you're Arthur's boss, you know where he is, right?
He's at the, office.
Where's the office?
I forget.
So when do you think Arthur will be leaving the office?
When I tell him he can leave the office. Hey, you missed a spot.
Isn't that Arthur McFly's hat you're holding?
It was McFly's hat. Now, it's my peanut bowl.
Could I buy Arthur's hat off you?
Could you keep your mind on your work, huh? Shoeshine boy? Hanging on to my peanut bowl.
Can I have some peanuts?
Why not? I'm a magnanimous kind of guy. Go ahead, knock yourself out.
Don't mind if I do.
All right, break time's over. Back to work.
About Arthur McFly.
Yeah?
So one more thing about that hack.
You're testing my patience, boy.
Never mind. How come you won't let the Stay Sober Society hold their meeting in the cellar of your soup kitchen?
We got other plans for that cellar, and it don't necessarily involve staying sober.
Hey, I represent United Charities of Hill Valley. Can you authorize me to pick up soup from your establishment and deliver it to some very deserving souls?
Nah, that Strickland dame's got the charity racket pretty much locked up. No point in giving her competition.
Edna Strickland thinks your soup kitchen might not be on the up and up.
That dame gets on my nerves. Got a great pair of gams, though.
So, one more thing about that hat.
You're testing my patience, boy.
I sure could go for some peanuts.
Lucky for you, I'm in a giving mood.
Hey, kid!
Yeah?
What the hell is that?
Hey! What'd you do? Give me that hat, you lousy crook! Emmett! A monkey out of Kid Tannen! Ow! Fix me up!
Where do you learn how to move like that?
Sandlot football. They used to call me the Streak.
Get out!
A cue ball.
What?
The truck just arrived with a fresh shipment of, soup.
Soup? Soup?
Well, this is the regular soup, and this is the special soup.
Right. Special.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm spicing up the soup. It's my secret recipe.
Listen, this ain't the Savoy, and we ain't here to feed these bozos no fancy soup. The boss has got a business to rebuild, so knock off the goofing and mind your post.
All right, just try the soup. Well?
I can see why you want to keep this a secret.
Excuse me.
You talking to me?
So this place used to be a soup kitchen.
What do you mean, used to be? Despite recent changes in ownership, this joint is still available for the purposes of distributing food to the needy and the not-so-well-to-do. And no other purposes whatsoever.
Right. What's a tough guy like Kid Tannen doing running a soup kitchen?
Mr. Tannen purchased the soup kitchen from the Sisters of Mercy in an effort to repair his reputation as a respectable community figure after his fine name was besmirched by the malignant and malicious the actions of the misguided vandals that done burned down his place of business.
Speak easy.
I cannot confirm nor deny any claims of so-called illegal bootlegging at the just eat your damn soup, Pipsqueak.
Why is the soup in a barrel?
Because it's hard to ladle off the floor.
Can I have a bowl of soup?
You're a soup kitchen. What do you think?
What kind of soup is this? It tastes like...
Scrolle ribollita?
I was gonna say week-old cabbage.
Everyone's a critic. Look, all I got to work with is this two-bit soup in a barrel and spice rack that hadn't been restocked since the Coolidge administration. What do you think I should do to perk this slop up?
Let's see. Have you tried... salt?
Salt? What, do you think it's too bland? Too mild? I didn't put too much pepper in it, did I?
I just think it could use a little more salt.
No accounting for taste these days.
Nice rack.
Yeah, we got all kinds of culinary enhancements back there. The kitchen's for management only, Rummy.
Whoa! Tables for?
We keep a few extra tables around for our end-of-the-month hobo soirees.
There's no way I'm gonna keep that door open without some help. Huddle up, Emmett.
Huddle?
Just listen up for a second. Any ideas about how to get the hooch?
Hooch?
The alcohol, Emmett.
One might come to the conclusion that the hooch is being hidden in some of those barrels.
You're probably right, but which ones?
Now, if I could get my hands on some of those barrels, I could weigh them and compare their specific gravity.
Specific gravity? Come on, Emmett. Kids' goons aren't going to let us do an experiment on their barrels.
Oh, I suppose you're right. We'll just have to ask the guy behind the counter.
What? Ask him if any of his barrels are filled with illegal moonshine? Get real here.
Well, I imagined a modicum of subtlety would be used.
Subtlety, right. Emmett, I can't get into the door over there. Those tables are jamming it shut.
The door? So your plan is to just waltz in there and take a barrel of alcohol?
No, of course not. That would be stupid, right?
I'll say.
Still, I'd like to get that door open. I can't do anything from out here.
Well, it's a simple matter of physics. A lever, some sort of stop. Let me see what I can come up with.
Are those all cabbage soup?
Last time I checked.
Don't you have any other kinds of soup?
No.
What about those barrels?
What about them?
What kind of soup is that?
It's not it's special soup.
What's special about it?
It's made for grown-ups, kid.
A soup for grown-ups?
That's right, kid. Be nosy. See where it gets you.
Eureka!
Nice rack.
Yeah, we got all kinds of culinary enhancements back there.
It's kind of blocked off there, isn't it?
Yeah, but what can you do?
Emmett.
Yes?
Oh, that's interesting.
Just a little mechanical ingenuity. In the end, the door is open.
Yeah, good job. Obviously, this kitchen isn't the speakeasy.
Indeed. This must be some sort of front meant to cleverly and legally obfuscate the existence of a hidden establishment of ill repute. Perhaps in the basement.
Right, that might explain the elevator. We'll score that hooch somehow.
I'll keep cogitating.
I hope Doc Jr.'s thingamabob holds out. Pretty neat, Doc. Nope. I'm still not getting through here. But at least those tables are propped up now.
What is it, kid?
Okay, I've got some more ideas about your soup.
Do tell.
Let's see. Have you tried giving the soup a little heat, maybe?
Why, is it getting cold?
No, I mean, like chili powder. Muy caliente.
Oh, bit of a tough guy, huh? Actually, I like it spicy too, but it's gotta be edible for the common folks.
Come on, a little dash isn't gonna kill anyone.
Aw, heck. You got moxie, kid. Let's spice it up a bit, shall we?
Pretty neat, Doc. Nope. I'm still not getting through here. But at least those tables are propped up now.
Miss Strickland, come for some more soup?
Come now, Mr. Donnelly. You know I wouldn't set one foot in this mockery of all that is good and decent if the poor of Hill Valley weren't so dependent on Mr. Tannen's overblown show of generosity.
Was that a yes?
Just give me the soup before I gag on the hypocrisy.
I'll tell the boss you said hello.
I'll just bet you will.
and then picked up the barrel of hooch. Now all I have to do is to get it from her somehow. Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Corleone. I'm afraid I haven't much time. The meeting of the Stay Sober Society is due to begin very soon.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
You can meet in the park.
No, that's no good. Too many of the members sleep in the park.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
You can meet over there in the jailhouse. I think they have an empty cell.
No, the jailhouse has bad associations for some of the Stay Soberites.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
You can meet in the speakeasy, the one that got bombed last Wednesday.
Now wouldn't that be poetic irony? But I'm not sure the building is structurally safe.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
The Brown residence.
You mean Judge Brown's place?
Yeah, I happen to be good friends with his son Emmett, and he's told me the judge would love to lend his place out for, you know, good causes like yours.
Really? Why, that's the most generous, public-spirited offer I've received in a month of Sundays. Please, tell your friend Emmett we accept. And the offer couldn't have come at a better moment. It's almost time for the meeting to begin.
You asked me to tell you if one of the local charities is running low on soup.
Does somebody need a visit from my soup cycle?
The rest home.
No, it's way past their bedtime.
I got a book.
Oh? Where?
We'll get that subpoena delivered. Hey, how you doing, Einie?
Einie?
It's short for Einstein.
Einstein, of course! Because he was a patent officer just like you.
Hey, honey. Come here for a sec, boy. Hey, boy. Can you find the guy who belongs to this hat?
Where's he going?
Only one way to find out. Huh. Deja vu.
Need any help?
Never mind. Thanks for bringing us here, boy. We'll take it from here.
Yeah? Who is it?
It's McFly!
Shh, I know! Hey, Arthur, can you come down a minute?
Do I know you?
We've got something for you.
It's a sub...
A subscription to the Accountant Weekly. He won't come out if he knows why we're really here.
No, right.
Ha ha ha! I'm not interested. And besides, the boss won't let me leave the room. Sorry. Some other time. What now?
It's me again. Please come down.
Why?
We've got some important information for you, but we can't yell it. It's private.
Then put it in a postcard and send it. I'm stuck up here till the boss tells me I can leave. Sorry. Some other time. What now?
I'll give it back to him after I give him the subpoena.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm throwing the subpoena.
You can't do that. You have to hand it to him.
It's me again. Please come down.
Why?
We represent the law.
You don't want to go against the law, do you?
No, but I don't want to go against Kid Tannen either. And he ordered me to stay put till he gives the word. Sorry. Some other time. What now?
I don't think Arthur would respond to that recording. He only listens to Tannen. Arthur's already a little freaked out. I think showing him a picture of his yet-to-be-born son could turn him into a vegetable. It's me again. Please come down.
Why?
I'm your grand... mother's great-nephew.
You mean my second cousin?
Yeah!
Glad to know you, but I can't leave this building till the boss says so. He's given strict orders. Sorry. Some other time.
Well, well, look who's back! They say rats always return to the scene of the sinking ship. Get him, Matches!
There, you son of a bitch! Right now.
Right now! That's an order! Don't make me angry, Smucko!
No way!
Get
We're
down here
to get
and
it.
Face the music!
I don't think they're in a talkative mood right now.
You can't get away
right
that
now.
Easy! Nobody puts one... ...over on Kid Tannen and lives to tell about it! You're dead
nah.
meat, twerp! Better start composing... Your epitaph now, because I'm going to carve it into your face! In both... Blitz! Get down here! What do you think you're doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now! You're only making it worse for yourself! The law...
Einstein! Help!
Lay off! away from me, you crazy mutt!
Go away, dog! We're busy here! Go on, scram! Hey! Where'd he go?
You let him get away, idiot!
What now?
What do you think you're doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now!
It's Kid! Right away, boss! Where's Kid? I'll give it back to him after I give him the subpoena. Arthur McFly?
Yeah?
Got something for you.
Thanks. A subpoena?
Ordering you to appear in court and provide evidence in the investigation into—
Kid Tannen? Take it back!
You can't get rid of it, Mr. McFly. Once you've been served, it's your duty to report to the court at the earliest possible time. Failure to do so could lead to a warrant for your arrest.
Arrest? But Kid'll kill me. Stupid Artie. Holy cats, what am I gonna do?
I suggest you avail yourself to the protection of the court.
Oh gosh.
Oh, I hate doing stuff like that. But I won't have to much longer.
No?
Once we get that 190 proof alcohol and build my rocket drill, my future will be set and I'll be able to quit this crummy job.
Oh, right. Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Corleone. I'm afraid I haven't much time. The meeting of the Stay Sober Society is due to begin very soon.
You asked me to tell you if one of the local charities is running low on soup.
Does somebody need a visit for my soup cycle?
The Stay Sober Society.
That's right. They'll soon be gathering at the Brown Estate, and we haven't provided refreshments. I can't get over the generosity of your friend Emmett volunteering his father's house for our meeting.
Huh? Wait there! Michael! What in the name of Thomas Alva Edison do you think you're doing?
Don't you get it? You need alcohol to run your drill, right? Those bootleggers at the soup kitchen won't let us get our hands on any of their hooch. But we can get Miss Strickland to pick it up for us and deliver it right to your door.
No, out of the question.
Why?
I can't just let strangers invade my parents' house. What do we know about these people?
They're sober. It says so right in the name.
Well, okay, but a pop needs his peace and quiet at the end of the day. This meeting is sure to be too noisy for him.
So get your dad a pair of earplugs.
I can't tell my father to wear earplugs.
What's wrong with a little noise? It'll be like a party.
My pop is not the partying type.
They'll be quiet. You'll be quiet, right?
Oh, yes. I play my tambourine very softly.
You hear that?
Yes, but...
But what?
But it's still impossible.
But I promise Miss Strickland, it means so much to her.
The answer is still no.
But think of the Stay Sober Society. What'll happen to them?
They can all fall off the wagon for all I care.
Okay, forget the whole thing. We don't have to test your rocket-powered drill tonight.
We don't?
No. I'll take the train back to Washington and I'll tell the folks at the office to give the patent to Dr. McCoy.
Wait! You will instruct the members of the society to wipe their feet before they come inside.
Then you are Emmett Brown. I thought as much. You have such a righteous face. Edna Strickland, I don't know how to thank you for your generosity.
Oh, pleased to meet you.
The feeling is mutual.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
You worry too much, Emmett. Well, we've served the subpoena and gotten a barrel of booze delivered to your house. Looks like we're off to your lab to build your rocket drill. You do have a lab, right?
What kind of future patent holder would I be without a lab? Come on!
Doc! I'm off to get the rocket drill.
Good! Come on, let's go! Time waits for no man!